Bonjour à tous et merci d'être sur Africa News. On fait l'actualité en RDC avec M. Trésor Kibangula, qui est analyste dans le groupe d'études sur le Congo. Cette motion de censure du Parlement contre le Premier ministre Sylvestre Ilunga, qui représentait la dernière figure pro-Kabila au sein de cette Assemblée nationale. Aujourd'hui, est-ce qu'on peut dire que le président Félix Tshisekedi s'affranchit encore un peu plus de la domination de l'ancien président Joseph Kabila?
Oui, le Premier ministre Sylvestre Ilunga
was the main link in the pro-Kabila political system at the central level and at the national level. His removal from office confirms above all the reversal of the balance of power that's been observed for several months now between former President Joseph Kabila and the new President Félix Tshisekedi. For several weeks now, Félix Tshisekedi has been regaining control of the institutions. There was the episode of the three constitutional court judges who were appointed by Tshisekedi without the agreement of Joseph Kabila. And there have been several other episodes, including the establishment of the army police force. What happened with the prime minister, and this is more of a confirmation, is that we already knew that the president of the republic was in the process of taking full control in May.
Et le président Félix Tshisekedi a affiché depuis un certain temps, depuis qu'il a annoncé en tout cas le divorce d'avec le parti de Joseph Kabila, une sorte d'union sacrée autour de lui. Il a désormais une assez large majorité au Parlement avec un peu plus de 390 sièges sur 500 et des alliés comme Jean-Pierre Bemba, Moïse Katumbi et également des ex-pro-Kabila. Une majorité assez hétéroclite. Est-ce qu'il aura les moyens de pouvoir satisfaire tous les appétits de ces différents clans?
C'est un défi énorme pour le président de la République.
It is a challenge and a huge one for the president. But the future of the Sacred Union will depend above all on his ability to impose a political line and a clear and consensual political agenda. Because as you have said, this coalition brings together quite heterogeneous profiles and above all people with very divergent interests. There are many who have come, especially those from the FCC, who came to join this board because they wanted to position themselves with regard to the weakening of their political family. There are other new supporters of Jean-Pierre Bemba and Moïse Katumbi who also came to try to have a look at the reforms, especially election reforms, which will be put in place because during the last elections, they were not candidates. They were invalidated. So it was an opportunity for them to come and play a role in what is going to happen. And there's also President Tshisekedi who is asserting himself. He will have a record to defend in 2023. So all these divergent interests must find common ground. And it will be up to the president to impose this line and his political vision.
Et finalement, Trésor Kibangula, il y a un grand absent sur cette scène politique de la RDC, c'est le président, l'ancien président Joseph Kabila, qui jusqu'à présent n'a pris aucune position. Quelle pourrait être, selon vous, sa riposte?
C'est difficile à lire depuis quelques temps.
It's been hard to read lately. The strategy of Joseph Kabila's responses. He was known to be powerful. It was said that he led the country for 18 years. He managed to have an overwhelming majority in the National Assembly. He still had connections within the army. He was someone who was supposed to be powerful. But lately, he's been accumulating defeats in the political arena. He has taken refuge in his village, in his farm in the south of the country. He's taking the blows. He's lying low for now. He set up a committee to think about crisis management, and his priority for now is to identify the lieutenants who have remained loyal to him and eventually craft a strategy.
Trésor Kibangula, thank you for responding to our questions on African News.
C'est moi qui vous remercie.